to welcome all our customers and partners today to this webcast. And most important, I'm so excited to introduce and welcome our new CEO, Satya Nadella. Welcome,
Thank
Satya.
You. Thank you so much, Susan. Thank you very much. And it's always, you know, it's such a great pleasure to have a chance that my first meeting externally is with customers, partners, and it's just always something that gives me a lot of energy. And so I'm glad this is one of the first things I'm doing in my new job.
Excellent. Well, before we dive in, would you mind starting with just a little bit about yourself and how you actually got here, this journey?
Sure. And, you know, it's a thing that I've actually reflected more on in the last, I guess, 24 hours than in the 22 years I've been at Microsoft. It's been an amazing journey. I was lucky enough at 24 joining the company. And I've had a tour of duty across a variety of different businesses. I started off in what became our server business, spent time in business applications, online in our advertising business and search, and then in the last 3 years in our enterprise and cloud business. And you know, it's been a great journey, but I think more than anything else, perhaps what defines me is, and this I've also understood exposed, is I'm a lifelong learner. I get energized when I see people achieve high standards in anything. At work, when somebody comes to me with an idea that they've implemented and it's something that I've not seen before, that's the thing that gets me going. I buy more books than I can finish. I sort of sign up for online courses more so than I can actually finish them, but I love it. And thank God for these new online courses where they even have 10-minute segments, so at least a sense of accomplishment is much easier.
It's like the new Cliff Notes.
Yeah, right? I wish I had it when I was growing up. But I think that that is perhaps more than anything else that gives me the energy. And it's not just the learning for learning's sake. What I think we all in business in particular thrive in is applied learning, to be able to take that, create products, create programs, approaches to how we work with customers and partners, and excelling in them, and being able to sort of both do that and more importantly learn from others who are doing it is what I would say defines me the most.
Well, it has been a very exciting day, starting out at 6 a.m. this morning when we had the announcement. I had the opportunity to speak with a number of customers around the world, as well as some of the customers that are joining us today. And there's been a number of great questions that I would like to pose to you. But maybe start. You sent an email out to all our employees this morning, and there were a couple of themes in that email that perhaps you can speak a little more to. One was about the software-powered world we're in, as well as mobility and cloud first. Can you speak a little bit in your own words what that means?
Sure. We've sort of talked about how our strategy going forward is about devices and services. Mm-hmm. And I said this also in my email, which is this business of ours is exciting because in some sense it doesn't really respect tradition and what we've done in the past. It's all about innovation going forward. Mm-hmm. And for us, and what's going to define Microsoft going forward is a mobile first, cloud first world. I was talking to Kevin, who's just done the worldwide tour of talking to all of our subsidiaries and the feedback. And we're living in this mobile first, cloud first world every day making progress. And so the question for us is, how do we thrive in that world? What new innovation can we bring? And if you look at it, for sure, the co-evolution of hardware and software is going to define a lot of what's going to happen. Today, we have a particular definition of mobile, which is perhaps skewed to saying, oh, it's just the mobile phone. But you take that and say the industrial internet or the internet of everything, everything is going to be connected to our cloud and data. And so that's the world that we are building for. And all of this is going to be mediated by software. Software is the most malleable thing that's going to define the experiences, the insights, the ambient intelligence that's going to power these device experiences. So to me, that capability, the heritage that this company has, is still very relevant. We have to renew it. We have to do new things. But at the same time, we should be very, very confident in our capability around software as it comes to these new experiences.
That's great. And, you know, we see so many examples of our customers now leveraging technology to enable new ways of doing business. And in particular, let's talk a little bit about devices. As a matter of fact, this morning, I had a chance to talk to one of our customers from BASF Dr. Blackburn, and his first question was around mobility. And in particular, he said, you've made a couple of big bets. One was around Surface, and now with the acquisition of Nokia, what does that mean? And if it's really a software-generated world, why are devices, what does it matter? Can you talk a little
Absolutely.
About
Absolutely. I mean, the devices are where these experiences come together. I mean, Surface Pro is a fantastic example. I mean, how does one define the boundaries of Surface Pro? It's definitely not defined by what's running on the device. A lot of the applications that run on the device have backends in the cloud. At the same time, the experience is in the device. So when we say mobile first and cloud first, Surface 2 is a fantastic example of it. So is a Windows Phone from Nokia. In fact, we are really looking forward to getting the regulatory approvals and starting the integration of Nokia, because I think that will bring core capability, which will amplify what we already have with Surface and Xbox in terms of devices. So the notion of being able to build these devices that encapsulate the rich experiences that users now expect, and the unique contribution I think Microsoft will make is our core capability around empowering us all. In fact, I love that Super Bowl ad. I think the tagline that we had there about sort of really our software being the thing that empowers everyone is the core of what we will do with the experiences on our devices.
Absolutely. No, it's absolutely a great opportunity for us. And some of the other questions that many have come from the audience here, as well as maybe your perspective in terms of the company. We have a strategy around consumer and business. Many have asked, how do those strategies come together? How do you think about consumer and business? And how do you see them benefiting each other?
You know, one of the things that when we think about our product innovation, we necessarily don't compartmentalize by consumer and business. We think about the user. In many of these cases, what needs to happen is experiences that for sure have to have a strong notion of identity and security. So IT control, where it's needed, still matters a lot. And that's something that, again, we will uniquely bring to market. But it starts with the user. The user obviously is going to have a life at home and a life at work. So how do we bridge that as they're more and more of what they do is digitally mediated? I want to be able to connect with my friends and family. Mm-hmm. I also want to be able to participate in a social network at work. And I don't want the two things to be confused, but I don't want to pick three different tools for doing the one thing that I want to do seamlessly across my work and life. Mm-hmm. That's what we are centered around. So when we think about what we are doing in communications, what we are doing in productivity or social communications, those are all the places where we really want to bridge the consumer and business markets, because that's how we believe end users actually work.
You mentioned something about security there as well. Can you talk a little bit about the importance?
One of the things that I think you see Microsoft, in fact, innovating a lot is we definitely have a devices and services strategy, which is going to come together in creating both these seamless experiences and creating great experiences for IT. Mm-hmm. What I mean by that, in fact, we kind of refer to this as people-centric IT, where the end user gets the experience they want, IT gets the control they want, and neither one of it is a compromise. Mm-hmm. And that value proposition of ours is, in fact, going to be cross-platform. We're going to have our identity management system, our endpoint security, our notion of device management, all of that will be cross-platform. So, for example, when we talk about our mobile strategy, it is, of course, inclusive of our own mobile devices, Surface and Windows Phone devices, from us and third parties, as well as it's the identity and device management and security that we want to bring to every enterprise across all of their platforms.
So it's a non-negotiable.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. As you look at, you mentioned about the consumer, it's in some ways it's interesting in that it's no longer that you say physically, I'm going to work. Sometimes we joke about that we work from home and shop from work. And how do you...
On a Cyber Monday, that's the fact. Right?
Probably not today, yeah. But in other days. Help me as well, maybe, and talk a little bit about the company. Our company has built a strong ecosystem, and we've built a strong platform in terms of working with partners of all sizes and all sizes of customers as well, from small, medium to large. Can you share a little bit about your perspective of, you know, why Microsoft is uniquely positioned, but also as you look to the future, how does the platform and partners play a role?
Yeah, no, this is something that I think is, again, just like the core software capability that's ingrained in everything we do. That's, in some sense, our DNA. That's how we approach it. This company was built on the thesis of enabling broad ecosystems, enabling broad partner opportunity. If you look at it, the PC ecosystem is one of the most broadest open ecosystems there ever was. We definitely now need to redefine what it means to build an ecosystem in a world that's evolving, in a mobile first, cloud first. There are new concepts that didn't exist in the past, like an app store. And one of the things that we want to do is make sure in everything we do, we bring new partnerships to bear as we approach these new scenarios. And that, I think, is what we will continue to push for. And anywhere, it's not about being static even in terms of defining any particular business model and any particular partnership model. It's about being able to evolve that going forward.
Absolutely. It's great that this morning you actually started out the day not only with an email to all our employees, but we had a great opportunity to meet with employees this morning. There's a lot of excitement. You made a comment, which was I wanted you maybe to speak a little bit about, but it was about being the technology being one of the industries that doesn't respect as much the tradition and the history, but in fact really values the innovation and the moving forward. How do you think about that, and what does that mean to you now as being the CEO of Microsoft and thinking about the opportunities that we have when it comes to innovation?
I mean, I think that's what makes this industry exciting, what makes our work in this industry exciting, which is the notion that every day you come to renew yourself with innovation. In fact, what you've done in the past, you know, is something that is in the rear view. And the question really would be, what is it that, you know, it has helped you create in terms of capability or culture that now needs to be renewed so that you can innovate in the future? And that's one of the things that I think has defined us. Microsoft exists today for having done that on a repeated basis for a long time. And in this cloud-first, mobile-first world, where software still is a very valuable, malleable resource to create these experiences, is where I think we're going to be very focused on. If you think about how everything that we do at home and at work is going to be digitally mediated, means that experiences such as online meetings at work, or how I connect and communicate with my friends and family, or how I consume content for entertainment are all going to be changed by software. And those are the places where Microsoft is squarely focused in bringing our innovation.
So software is really behind the strategy, just as, you know, big history here, but looking forward, that's where innovation
software
will happen.
Embodied in our devices and services is, I think, the real place. And in that context, Microsoft has a pretty unique role to play.
That's great. Well, you know, I know it's been a big day and a lot of questions in terms of, so as you think about, you know, we've presented so many interesting ideas in terms of, you know, day one, what's your priorities and what does the next, you know, month look like? And could you share a little bit about overall strategy and sort of where you expect to be spending your time?
Absolutely. The first thing is both internally and externally, there's a lot to learn. I've, as I said, spent a lot of time in Microsoft, but there are also parts of Microsoft that are going to be new to me. We have Nokia joining our company when the deal's closed. So therefore, I think there is definitely a lot to learn for me. The three constituents that I'll spend a lot of time with is customers, partners, and investors. And so I'll be on the road meeting with all of the folks and across these constituents, making sure I have my best listening skills, because I think that being in touch with both perceptions and grounded in our realities is what's going to help us do our best work going forward. I'm blessed to have a fantastic leadership team at Microsoft with Kevin and others on the SLT who have been running this business very, very successfully. And so therefore, with their help, I plan to ramp up very, very quickly. And that's job number one. The second thing I'd also say is our strategic frame that we have around devices and services is great. It's in motion today. As I said, it's not like we're waiting for our entry into a mobile-first, cloud-first world. We are there. We just are going to keep coming to it again and again with every one of our launches and every one of our services. But one of the things that we will also want to do is get more specificity and more focus on what is it that we can uniquely do. So when the next time we do something in meetings, it's something that we will say, wow, Microsoft did that by bringing their assets and ingenuity, which is not replicable by others. And that's the focus that we will bring to our execution.
I know we're leveraging a lot of that of how we're actually running the company and how we're moving to a digital business and taking a lot of that learning. I know you've been very involved in that as well.
Yeah, no, I'm very, very excited. We have this Go Digital initiative inside at the company, and you know, everything from what we're doing on the PPI big screen side to what we're doing on our tablets and phones. And in fact, one of the things that we all realize that it's not about one single device anymore. You know, if you're like me, we are in, I believe the average customer today has four devices and they want to roam between all of those, and constructing those experiences is what definitely is front and center for us.
Well, this has been just an incredible opportunity to get a chance to both share some of the great questions that came from customers around, partners around the world, small, medium, large customers, and customers in the room with us. I know it's a big day with lots of days to come, but it's been a real honor to have you and your first day to really reach out and make sure you connected with all our great customers and partners around the world. So thank you so much, Satya. Please join me in welcoming
you so much.
Thank you so much.
It's a real pleasure. Thank you.